there are many different triangulations which are possible. And I can use this information by to construct what is called a visibility, that is the Fourier transform in the two-dimensional Fourier transform of the brightness of the image. I will explain this a bit more in detail. Each baseline represents a point in this space, in the Fourier space. And as the Earth rotates and the baseline changes, this point will trace a track of different color. And on the basis of the information on this space, you can build an image. So this is the image, the brightness, the way it looks like on the sky. X and Y are the coordinates, the projected coordinates in the sky. And U and V are the baseline of the two telescopes. So this is a two-dimensional complex Fourier transform, pretty much the same as we are used when we do Fourier transform from time to frequency. Just here you are transforming in two spatial quantities in two spatial quantities. And out of this information, you can build an image. Okay? So you have to go from here, from the visibility over to an image. And this is a bit like going from the power spectral density in frequency over to a time series. As time goes on, these tracks fill the UV plane, the Fourier space. You see there is more color here, the tracks are larger, and you have a better image because you are sampling different scales, or if you want, the